Game four of the NVL tournament is just moments away from tip here at Wilby High School in Waterbury, Connecticut. Chris Saunders alongside Tom Felice here as we have the number one seed, the Waterbury Career Academy Spartans, take on the number eight seed, the Naugatuck Greyhounds. Naugy 10-10, 9-9 in the NVL. And then you've got the Spartans 17-3. They are 16-2 in the NVL. Tom, we saw an exciting game between Seymour in their last game against the Crosby Bulldogs. And now we have, with this game four being the 1-8, a lot of people would think that this should be Career Academy if there was a spread by a good margin. But in seeing, you know, in seeing Naugatuck like I have quite a few times, they are a tough team. Coach Wilson really knows how to get his players ready. And they're going to compete for the full 32 minutes.
Yeah, Waterbury Career Academy has been the best team in the league season. That's obvious. They had the best record over an 18-game schedule. That's what the best team is. But now, tournament play is different. Their NVL season could be over in 32 minutes if they don't come to play. And I think seeing these players, especially the seniors like Sonny Pierce and Jason Kennedy, that these guys want to prove something. They want to prove that they are the best team in the league, and you do that during the regular season, but you put an exclamation point on it by winning the conference tournament. So Waterbury Career Academy knows they need to come to play, and the scariest thing is Ron O'Leary is quoted in the Republican American saying, "I'm not sure if we've played an entire 32 minutes yet." And you look, they've scored 90 points eight times, including their final three games of the regular season. And Coach O'Leary still thinks there's another gear in there for his Spartans.
And that's scary to think about, that for a team that's not even, you could say, playing at 100%, and they're playing at, let's say, 75 to 80 of their talent level, if they were to play at 100, I mean, this is a program that has not won. I mean, their, you know, the program's inception was the 2015-2016 season. Their first NVL season was the 2016-2017. They have not won an NVL title, and they also have not won a state title. This team has the capability, with how deep they are and also how talented they are, that those two big-time goals that I think every coach strives for could be made. But they ought to be able to do what you just said, play a full 32.
And they haven't been to an NVL championship game. I believe they made one state semifinal. But on the other side, credit to Naugatuck. Obviously, they had the great season last year, undefeated in the league, won the conference tournament, and then they lost all five starters, and I think the expectations were this was going to be a down year.
Yep.
And you know what? Naugatuck came out 10-10 on the season, 9-9 in the NVL. And they get to play today, and they'll play in the state tournament as well.
This is a Naugatuck team that, over their course of the 3 years, they probably had their best team on paper the year that COVID canceled the CIC state playoff, when they had Derek Jagello, and they had a very young Essayonic Poma, Avery Hinnett. Hinnett's now playing at Albertus Magnus, who I think they're competing against St. Joe's in a couple days for the GNAC title. But you just think about Robert Sanders as well. They had so many players over the course of the years. That, you know, at some point that pipeline was going to shorten a little bit, right? They were going to need a year or two to recalibrate. Well, not a bad year to recalibrate when you're 10-10 in a very balanced NBL after losing, like you said, six starters.
Yeah, and, you know, they pulled it out. They beat Torrington by five in the final game of the season. They didn't have the best record coming down the stretch, but they played a lot of the Brass Division teams in that stretch, and now an opportunity to prove themselves on the big stage.
The starting five for the Naugatuck Greyhounds, the number eight seed, 9-9 in the NVL, 10-10 overall. You've got number zero, Thomas Berry. Number one, Dylan Gray. Number two, Jalen Francis. Number three, Caden Moore. Number 54, Jabari Gray. The starting five for the Greyhounds.
Three of those players are over 6'2", I believe. Or all four of those players are over 6'2". Mm. Waterbury Career Academy doesn't have a lot of height. They want to get up and down, and if Naugatuck can slow it down and use that height, they can keep themselves in the game against Waterbury Career Academy.
Starting five for the Spartans, coached by Ronan O'Leary in his eighth season. Number two, junior Zaire Law. Number three, senior, Jason Kennedy. Number 11, Dasani Yates. Number 12, senior, Sonny Pierce. And number 24, junior, your favorite player, Drew Williams. Fan favorite of Utah.
Oh, yeah.
Fan favorite.
He's the shortest player in the starting lineup, but he's second on the team in rebounding. He's fourth on the team in scoring, but when you average almost 17 points a game, you're not really worried about where you sit on your team rankings. And he always seems to be in the middle of it. He's a very impressive player, but one of many impressive players on Waterbury Career Academy this year.
These teams played back on January 13th in terms of a matchup, and Career Academy won. And, you know, or correction, I apologize, that was January 4th. That was 83-51 in favor of the Gray, or in favor of Career, trying to get those points across there. It's been a long day here at Willby High School. But, you know, I've always been intrigued by when teams match up again. And right now this is the second matchup, and obviously you know that Naugatuck is going to have their, you know, their adjustments. They also know how talented they are. That goes without saying. But I'll be curious to see, like we saw with Seymour, Tom, trying to slow the game down and make Crosby playing to their pace. What do you think that Nagy will do here with Career Academy?
I think if you can, you slow it down. But I think that's been a lot of people's plans against Waterbury Career Academy, and it hasn't been too successful throughout the season.
Naugy will be in their maroon, Waterbury Career Academy in their white, and we are underway. The opening tip begins with the Spartans. That's Sonny Pierce from the free throw line, a little bit short. Second chance for the Spartans, that's Pierce. Spartans will be going left to right on your screen. Naugatuck right to left. Game four of the NVL tournament between number 8 Naugy, number 1 Career. Jason Kennedy on the spin. Kennedy comes up empty. 0-for-2 are the Spartans on their first two possessions, and now Naugatuck has a chance here. About 30 seconds into the first quarter. Gray. The Caden Moore, number 3. The long player is Caden Moore. Moore on the drive, lost it, but he traveled. First turnover by the Greyhounds in the game. .723, well early in the first, inbounding will be Jason Kennedy to Drew Williams. Four of the five starters, as Tom alluded to earlier in game three and also in the pregame in game four, averaging double figures. Working outside, Zaire Lott to Drew Williams. Drew Williams to Kennedy. Kennedy pump fakes on Barry. Give and go to Yates. Yates, nice pass, and the foul, and counting. Zaire Lott for 2, possible 3-point play, first team foul on Naugy.
Lott had a good game here against Willby on Tuesday night. He scored 27 points, added 7 rebounds, 6 blocks. And of course, he has a bit of a legacy to live up to in this gym. His father's number is retired on the wall to our left. Phil Lott sitting courtside watching his son play for Waterbury Career Academy.
3-0 is the score. Naugy down by 3 to the Spartans. Gray posting up on Williams. Right hand a little bit too strong. Offensive rebound by Moore. Moore spinning by Yates. A little bit too hard. 0-for-2 are the Greyhounds. Here go the Spartans in transition. And Zaire Lott with a nice finish using those long arms. And he quickly has 5. All 5 for the Spartans. And a timeout call by Coach Wilson. 6:36 to go in the first. Tom, you've seen Career enough to know that when you get into a transition game with the Spartans, it's kind of tough.
You're going to be out of the game pretty quickly if you get in a transition game against Waterbury Career Academy. And I think that's part of the reason that Mike Wilson called timeout. You know, it's only 5-0. We've only played a minute and a half, but he does not want his team in a position where they are getting into a track meet with Waterbury Career Academy.
Now, this is a Spartans team that had a 11-plus game win streak at one point during the season. They've only lost 3 games. They lost to Danbury back on December 21st. They lost to Kennedy back on the 27th of January. And they lost to Holy Cross on February 7th. That's it as far as losses.
The one thing to think about, though, is those 2 conference losses were by 17 points and 23 points. So they've laid a couple of eggs, and you can't do that anymore the rest of this year. You're not going to get easy games at any point the end of February or March.
Back-to-back turnovers by both teams, one each, missed by Francis. And with Caden Moore, he puts it back in for the easy two, wearing number three. Naugy has their first points of the game, 5-2. Career Academy only up by three with about 2 minutes through this first quarter. Chris Sorens alongside Tom Felice. Sonny Pierce for three, comes up cold there on the missed three. Moore on the offensive rebound. Francis trying to cut it to one, and he's fouled. Two free throws coming for Jalen Francis. Fouls on Sonny Pierce, his first, team's first. You think of Jalen Francis, Tom. I mean, he sat behind some pretty big-time players. Essayonic Poma, you think about Jigello, you think about as the first free throw. Will be just good. To sit behind all that talent, Tom, I mean, and now he has an opportunity. This is his first year starting. I mean, that's got to be humbling to a degree, but also appreciative as well.
His father's an assistant coach, so he's been around the program. He's seen what this program is capable of and the success they've had over the past couple of seasons, even if he hasn't been an active participant. And it puts him in a good position to lead this team, not just this year, but next year too.
Drew Williams on the drive, comes up empty there again. Stays 5-4 in favor of Career. Naugy trying to find their first lead. Francis on the reverse, and there it is. Francis with four. Naugy leads by one, 6-5.
Six straight points for Naugatuck.
Missed three by Career. Now Caden Moore on the offensive rebound, rather defensive rebound. Dre lost the handle. Yates picks it up for the Spartans. A lot to Sonny Pierce. Number one Career, number eight Naugy. The final game here in the quarterfinal. The winner will take on Seymour on Monday. Drew Williams to Zaire Law. Sonny Pierce inside the three-point line. Pump fakes near the charity stripe. Give and go. Sonny Pierce was pushed, but it doesn't matter. He gets the basket plus a possible three-point play.
And how about that pass from Yates?
Yep.
Yates, someone going to play football at Southern Connecticut. And they expect to see him on the defensive side of the ball, but that was a very good look by Yates to connect that pass.
That was on Barry, his first, team second. Sonny Pierce at the line for a possible three-point play. No, comes up short, hit the front iron. So Career, one of two from the stripe. Naugy, two of two. Under five to play in the first. Career leads by one, 7-6. Francis kicks it outside to Barry for three. No, misses the three. Lot on the defensive rebound using those long arms, Tom.
He's a very capable rebounder.
Yates outside. Pierce, three. Misses the three. Francis, defensive rebound. There's Moore. And he tries to go for the dunk and missed the dunk. And that's not going to make Coach Wilson happy. That's an easy two that was missed.
Well, he doesn't look visibly upset, and I think he understands, you know.
He gave the stare.
Yeah, well,
he gave the stare.
But at the same time, you know, you want a player feeling comfortable, and if he thinks he can do it, let him go and give it a shot. Obviously, it didn't work, and I think that might be a lesson for next time.
Zaire Locke kicks it outside to Jason Kennedy for the triple. A little bit too hard. And that's going to be Valmy on the defensive rebound. A nice player off the bench for Naugatuck, number 33.
Yeah.
Also has some hops as well, as the kids say. Barry able to regain. Whistle blown for a travel.
Yeah, he was down on a knee and stood up.
Yep.
And he had already ripped the ball away. If it was still a held ball, obviously it would have been a jump ball alternate possession. Mm-hmm. But once Barry had possession and stood up, it was going to be a travel.
In football, that would be victory formation.
Yeah.
Or going into halftime.
Yeah.
Jason Kennedy driving. He was fouled. Two free throws coming for Jason Kennedy. And that will put now three starters for Career Academy who are at the line or have been at the line at one point in this first quarter. Fouls on Barry, his second, team's third. Kennedy averages 17 points per game. This is a free throw there. Would you say, Tom, that, and I don't know how much of a believer you are in trap games, would this be considered a trap game for a Career?
I guess so. Like it's, you know, I don't think they're, you know, I think this is, if you're going to look over any game, it's going to be this one, obviously. It's your first game in the tournament.
True.
And, you know, maybe it's just playing on Saturday is different. The tip time is different.
Zaire Lott on the drive. He was fouled. And now he'll be at the line for two free throws instead of one. He was one for one at the line on an and one. They'll be on Francis. That's going to be his first, team's fourth. Zaire Lott, you mentioned about his father's banner being here for the amount of points he scored during his time playing at Wilby. This is a free throw here. Also is known for making a fantastic shot against Darien.
Yep.
Which is known around Waterbury as the shot. Free throws made. Two of six. Lott now with 6 points. Career leads by three with 3:30 to go in the first. 9-6. Dietelbaum into the game for Nagy for the first time. Francis swarmed by two. It goes out of bounds. Possession stays with Nagy. And this is a Greyhound team that only has a couple seniors, Tom, so this experience, I think, will help them a lot going forward over the course of the next couple of years.
Absolutely, but for them, I think they're thinking, what can we do today? What can we do in the NVL tournament? And then, remember, they're in Division One for the state tournament, so every game they have in the state tournament is going to be a test. They'll probably start off against Ridgefield, going for another FCAC title this week.
Balmy missed the bunny in the left low post. Career Academy keeps it alive. That was Zaire Lott. From Yates to Kennedy. Kennedy. Left hand floater, no. Valmy on the defensive rebound, picked it back up, gives it to Dietelbaum. Dietelbaum looks to Gray. A little bit of size from Naugatuck between Moore, Dietelbaum, and Valmy.
Yates is 6'2", Lott is 6'3" for career. Lott doesn't play like a big, but he's still 6'3", but he plays kind of a modern game.
Francis back outside to Moore. Moore probably won't shoot a three, not a big-time three-point shooter. Nagy not very high as far as three-point shooting percentage this season.
Well, and Waterbury Career Academy is in a zone. They're giving the opportunities for Naugatuck to shoot the three, almost daring them to take the shots from deep.
Almost like to grab the bait, right?
Yep.
2:25 to go in the first. A three-point lead for career, 9-6. Nagy really taking the air out of the basketball here. Still passing around outside the three-point line as Nagy goes right to left on your screen. Loose ball stolen away by Career. Drew Williams in the corner to Kennedy. Kennedy to Drew Williams. Pulls up, and it's a little bit short off the front iron. Moore on the defensive rebound. Here goes Francis. Francis, one pass over to Gray. Whistle blown, and he traveled. Under two to play in the first, 9-6, career. Drew Williams wearing number 24. Sonny Pierce, Desire Lock, catch and shoot three. No, misses the three off the back side of the rim. Dietelbaum to Gray. Gray to Francis. Francis has 4 of the 6 points for Nagy. The lone 2 coming from Moore. Gray number 1. One bounce to Caden Moore. Moore back outside to Francis over the hand of Williams, and it's a little bit short. Wide open is Zaire Lott. All by his lonesome, and Lott will slam it home. Have a quarter, young man. Zaire Lott with a minute to go. 11-6 career over Nagy.
Lott has 8 of the 11.
Yes, he does. Gray. Horizontal pass to Francis, down to 50 seconds in the first. If you're Nagy, you have to be pretty pleased with the score right now. I mean, it's close.
Yeah, you're happy to be within 5, but the problem is Waterbury Career Academy hasn't hit a 3 yet, and you know that's going to start coming.
That's true.
They're playing this zone defense, and Naugatuck hasn't had an answer for it.
Valmy, nice play, the assist from Francis.
Talked about it in the last game. Get the ball into the center of the zone,
yep,
and good things can happen for you.
3-point lead for Career Academy, down to under 20 seconds in the first in game 4 of the NVL tournament. Drew Williams going inside over the trees, and it'll go out of bounds. Possession, Nagy. And you mentioned too, and it's funny, not funny, but it's great that you mentioned it because I haven't heard anybody else really say it in other broadcasts. The size of Career Academy, while very talented, they don't have the height. They have length, but there's a difference between height and length.
Yeah, and, you know, Zaire Lott, he's got some length, but he doesn't play as a big, which is not to his detriment.
Three by Nagy. It's an air ball. Goes out of bounds. Stepping out of bounds. Stays with Nagy. Tom, you were saying?
And so it really leaves Dasani Yates as the only anchor big type of player. And if he gets in foul trouble, there's no other option.
Valmy before the buzzer. Yes, he finds it. He has four. And what a nice execution by Naugatuck going into the end of the first quarter. Only down by one. And I mentioned the trap game. I know it's early, but this Naugy team, they're a bunch of fighters. They will not go down without a fight.
And I think Career just hasn't found their rhythm. And if you haven't found your rhythm and you're up by a point, you're okay. I think the lesson needs to be there will be games where if we start like this, we're going to be down by eight. And maybe that's insurmountable given the opponent. So Waterbury Career Academy with a chance to reset here at the break end of the first quarter.
Neither team has attempted a three, or rather not made a three, I should say. They've attempted some threes, but neither has been able to make a three. For Career Academy, you've got eight from Zaire Lott and from Naugatuck. Two players with four, that's Jalen Francis and Valmy, number 33. This is a Naugy team that has won NVL titles in two of the last three seasons. The lone season they did not win over the last three was in 2021. They were in the but they came in second place to the Sacred Hearts, who they won their final game before they closed during the COVID season. So this is a Greyhounds team, like we talked about with Crosby and expectations. This Naugy program, even if they don't have the big name players, there still is a expectation to be at certain points at certain spots of the season.
And these players didn't necessarily see a lot of time on the court over the past couple years when Naugatuck had all their success, but you know they were around the team, they were on the bench or in the stands, understanding what these games are like.
Correct. Swarming is strained inside. Yates takes it away. Career Academy has the basketball, and then a reach-in foul by Naugy. That'll be their fifth.
That's a bailout, too, as Yates isn't necessarily a player you want bringing the ball up the court and looked like he was losing possession as Dietelbaum reached in and fouled him.
Dietelbaum's first, as I mentioned, team's fifth. Inbounding will be Drew Williams, three-fourths of the court on the Naugy side. Career in their white uniforms. They go left to right on your screen. Lop for three. A little short. Career Academy still yet to shoot and make a three. They keep shooting them. They're just not going down.
And I think they're going to keep shooting them, and eventually they're going to start falling.
I mean, they made 163 during the regular season. As that ball, I don't know if the ref wasn't in the way.
Yeah.
I think Zaire Lott probably is a one-on-one between him and Barry.
Yeah, Barry had position, so it might not have been an easy hoop for Lott, but it is a bad break. And, of course, in the NVL tournament, they have three officials, and that certainly makes it easier to officiate the game, and you just have one situation where the official is in the way.
Moore was fouled by Yates. His first, team's second. At the line for two is Caden Moore, who had 2 points in the first quarter. I've talked about Moore and how long he is, and you'll probably find this funny. He's longer than a Monday.
I heard you use that recently.
Did you?
Yeah.
Okay.
But different audience today, but no, it's true. And you know, he's listed at 6'4", the tallest player on the team. And he's not skinny. He's skinny, but he's not like a stick. You know, he's got a little bit of width to him. Be very interesting to see how he develops over this offseason, but I don't think he's done this year either. He makes both free throws.
Naugy not known for making their free throws. They're 4-4 from the line. They're up by one over the one seed Career. 2 minutes into the second quarter, Lott for three. Comes up cold there. Career still yet to make a three. And a jump ball call, possession Career. Like you said, you know, you would think career eventually will make threes, but at one point do you start getting nervous and maybe stop trying to shoot threes because maybe they're just not going in?
I don't know, the fourth quarter?
That could be a good point. Up by one is Naugy. Pierce driving, whistle blown at the line for two. That'll be unstrained. His first, team six, the team fouls piling up for Naugatuck as Gray waiting to come back in. At the line for two free throws is Sonny Pierce, 0 for 1 from the line. Now 1 for 2. Career Academy was 2 of 6 in the first quarter, now 3 of 7 from the stripe.
Yeah, they've had some days where it doesn't work from the free throw line either, and they need to be able to take advantage and make a couple of shots from the stripe, especially now with 16 fouls and 7 minutes to go in the first half.
Free throw missed, 3 of 8 from the free throw line is career. Pierce stays with 3 points. The missed drive by Naugy. We are tied still 12-12. Outside, Pierce for the lead, yes! 15-12, career. Into the game for the first time is Aiden Cross, number 5.
You see Dylan Rossi as well. He is a big like Yates.
Drew Williams, he can't make the bunny. Pierce, he can't make it either. Ball goes to the side of the Naugy bench. Diving forward is Pierce, but went out of bounds. Possession Naugy. And Rossi kind of gives them that second big, although he's not a big in terms of height, but gives a little bit of girth in that center.
And he's probably 6'2", 6'3". As we see Moore walk by him, he adds enough height. Let's put it that way.
Just enough. Francis, horizontal pass to Gray. Gray working on Rossi. Gray went in contested, and he's fouled. Two free throws for Gray, number 1. Fouls on Lott, his first. Now Lott, Yates, and Pierce each have one personal foul. Gray looking for his first points. Naugy's been perfect from the line, 4 of 4. First free throw, good, make it 5 of 5. Second free throw is no good. Rossi fighting for it. Cross for career has it. 1 of 2 was Gray from the line. Career 5 of 6 from the free throw line. 2-point lead for career. Pierce trying to make it 5. Misses the 3. And a reach-in foul on career.
And I'll go against Rossi.
His first, team's 4th. So what are your thoughts as far as seeing Naugatuck through a quarter in almost 2 minutes?
You can tell they have a game plan and they're sticking to it, and it's allowing them to stick with the top team in the league. But it's going to be those individual battles like that that they need to go 500 on.
Lott now with 10 as he makes the bunny in the left low post. 5:25 remaining in the first half, 17-13 career. Game 4 of the NVL tournament from Wilby High School in the Reggie O'Brien Gymnasium. Chris Arnes alongside Tom Felice. Barry to Francis, back to Barry. Barry 3/4 of the court. Down to 5 minutes remaining in the first half. Gray swings it over to Francis. And then Lott, maybe hard foul, we'll call it that. Team's fifth, Lott second.
Lott staying on the court for the moment. Looks like Coach O'Leary is checking the foul situation.
Moore working on Rossi. Rossi and you could say the two other Spartan players win the battle. 17-13 Spartans. Williams trying to drive. Williams can't complete the possible 3-point play, but he'll be at the line for 2. Francis is 2nd, team's 7th. And how about Drew Williams, held scoreless thus far, Tom? looking for his first couple points here. Misses the free throw.
But he affects the game in so many ways. Mm-hmm. Obviously, you want to score points. Everybody wants to score points, but I don't think this team needs him to score points to be successful.
Williams' second free throw is good. Substitution coming in as Palmy is in. Dietelbaum is out. So what you're saying is Williams, even though he's not scoring, he does things that are not technically recorded in a scorebook that you have to watch the game to be able to realize.
Yes. He's second on the team in rebounding, second on the team in assists. Hmm.
Francis, guarded by two to Barry. Break the mini press. Gray. Wherever the basketball is, we're seeing two players swarm. Francis, three. No from the top of the key. Valmy goes in and was fouled. Two free throws for Valmy. Team sixth. Fouls on Rossi. Two personal fouls. First free throw is missed by Valmy. Naugy now has missed back-to-back free throws after starting the game 5-5.
You need every point you can against a team like the Spartans.
Yes. Second free throw is missed. Last three free throws missed by the Greyhounds. Pierce trying to make them pay. Valmy's able to swat it away. Nice play by Valmy, able to stand his ground and hold strong in that weak side in the right low post.
Yeah, he's stepping up, coming off the bench. You know, he's a senior. All of a sudden, you start to feel a little urgency when you're a senior.
Jason Kennedy got it over Valmy. Drew Williams on the rebound. And a whistle blown. I wonder if they're going to call that on Moore.
I think it's the only option.
Yeah, I was going to say, there was nobody else near Williams other than Caden Moore. Yep. His first, team's eighth. At the line for a 1-1 will be Drew Williams. Only 1 point for number 24. The junior averages 16. Made the second of two free throws early in this quarter. Misses the 1-1. Valmy on the defensive rebound. And then Kennedy's able to intercept it. Kennedy misses the bunny in the left low post. It goes out of bounds. Possession stays with Career. So neither team shooting too well from the free throw line. Career this entire game so far. They're 4 of 11. For Naugy, they missed their last three.
A lot of points left on the floor.
Yep. Cross does a reverse to Kennedy. Career going left to right on your screen in their white uniforms. Naugy defending in their maroon. Cross drawing two. Williams three. Bang! Williams needed that three, maybe to kind of get him out his scoring funk that he did not have in this first half. He has 4 points. The second made three by Career in this first half. 21-13 Spartans. 3:49 to go in the first half.
Zaire Lott leads the way for WCA. He has 10 points, but he picked up a second foul about a minute ago, and he's sitting on the bench. Don't know if we're going to see him again the rest of this first half. And it just changes the rhythm of the offense a little bit, you know. He is such a good player. He's tall. He can shoot the three, but he can get to the hoop as well. He's a versatile offensive player, and so it changes the setup of the offense when he's not out there, and everyone else needs to adapt. And we just saw Williams hit a three to stretch this lead to eight, the largest it has been so far.
Back out on the court, we've got for Naugatuck, Francis, Gray, Moore, Valmy, and Barry. Barry inbounding behind his own basket. Valmy to Francis, they break the press. Gray floats it to Moore. Moore is able to finish, but not before some contestion from Career. Moore with 6 points. 21-15 Spartans. Kennedy to Pierce. Drew Williams, top of the key, rather to the left side of the top of the key, misses the three. Keeping it in bounds was Career, but they throw it to Naugy, and then Moore quickly with 4 points. 21-17, Naugy chipping away, Tom, little by little.
And you can tell that they're well coached. Out of that timeout, They were able to go the length of the floor and get an easy hoop. They're playing well on defense.
Kennedy, guarded by Barry. Kennedy to Williams. Williams to Sonny Pierce, quickly guarded by Francis. Now Kennedy from the top of the key. Pure! Missed a chance for a steal. And then a blocking foul on Williams. That's his first. Team seventh, 1-1 time for Nagy. If you're Wilson, you have to be pleased that you forced Career to now, in some ways, although not much, to basically stop shooting threes to a high percentage and start driving to the basketball.
There's more to that. You need to see.
Yates is able to keep out by Dasani Yates. Boy, he's got a fair point.
Your academy is how they'll be a little over-aggressive in spots where it's just not necessary. We saw Williams pick up the foul along the sideline a couple of possessions ago, and now Yates, who is really the third defender in against Francis.
And now Rossi's back in. First free throw made by Francis. He's got five, may get six.
And I think it was that play where Williams committed the foul. Yep. It started with one of the guards going for a steal in the backcourt, and then when he doesn't get it, it's 5-on-4.
The lead is three for the Spartans, 24-21. Nagy staying in the game. Kennedy, three. No, misses off the front iron. One and done is Career. The longer that Career keeps Nagy in the game, the confidence continues to grow for this team. Under two to play. But as I say that, they throw a turnover there for Career. Pierce to Williams. 6 points for Drew Williams. 5 point lead for Career. 1:40 remaining in the first half here from Wilby High School. Valmy to Moore. Moore working on Rossi, and he double dribbled. And the thing is too, he knew it.
Yeah.
He knew it very quickly.
If I saw Dylan Rossi standing in my way, I'd hold on to the ball, and I think, too. Rossi is a big presence down low, and he's just a sophomore.
Dietobaum waiting to come back into the game. Was a radium once for a good amount of time. Pierce all by his lonesome. Off the front iron again. Stays a five-point lead for Career. 1:17 remaining in the first half. Francis has 6 points. Six of the 21, and a timeout call by Coach Wilson with 1:08 to go in the first half. We've seen Naugatuck do what they have against Career without making a three yet, which is a good sign. Now, vice versa, the Spartans have made three in the second quarter. Are they heating up? Are they just, you know, still trying to find their footing from the three-point line? Where exactly do you think they are right now?
Well, I think they're going to keep taking them regardless. So
100%.
We know that part.
That goes without saying.
Yeah, and I think they've gotten some good looks. They just haven't fallen. You know, they made plenty of them Tuesday night in this same gym. They scored 99 points. So I don't think they're too worried about it at this point, especially with a five-point lead.
Now, if you're just tuning in on YouTube, I'm Chris Saunders alongside Tom Felice. First three games were as follows. You had Holy Cross beat Torrington 83-42. You had Kennedy defeat Wilby, Kennedy number two, Wilby number seven, 64-52. And then you had Seymour defeating the Crosby Bulldogs 67-60. And that was Seymour's first win over Crosby in 20-plus seasons. So, and now the winner of this game will play Seymour on Monday, or depending on what Mother Nature would like.
Yeah.
Because we can never predict Mother Nature.
No, I think Monday's the safest bet. It's a lot of people are worried about Tuesday if schools will be open on Tuesday.
1:08 to go in this first half. 5 point lead for Career. Dietobaum to Barry. Pierce going for the steal. Nagy keeps the handle of the basketball. Gray, and a travel by Gray. We've seen that called a lot on Nagy, the amount of travels.
Yeah. Oh, and for Waterbury Career Academy, they play a little differently. They don't feed the ball into the post like that too often, so most of the time their players are going to the rim, a lot less susceptible to being called for a travel.
Drew Williams to Sonny Pierce. Back outside to Kennedy. working on Barry. Loose ball in the corner. Nice job by Aiden Cross to know that if he touched it, it would have been Nagy ball, and he went to shield mode.
Yeah.
Heads up play.
And you don't want to grab the ball in the corner. You get stuck. So it's a good chance to maintain possession just by letting the ball go out of bounds.
Sonny Pierce down to 33 seconds in this first half. 5-point lead for Career. Kennedy fouls, he shot it. Rossi on the offensive rebound. Finds Pierce. They miss another shot, does Career. Third chance for the Spartans. Williams will miss as well. Rossi trying to still keep it alive for the Spartans. They have it. Pierce, as the whistle's blown, possession, Naugy. Looks like an elbow by Waterbury Career Academy. I think they got...
Now Rossi.
Yes. That's quickly his third, team's ninth. The lone player in foul trouble for Career is Rossi. And that's kind of important.
Well, he's in foul trouble because Dasani Yates and Zaire Lott are on the bench with two fouls.
That's
so
true.
Rossi
that's
is in the game
that's
to
true.
Protect those guys who have two each.
And Lott has 10 points of the 26 as well.
Yeah, and he won't play for the final 5 minutes of the first half with those two fouls.
Yep. Barry to Moore, working on Rossi. Nice reverse by Moore, going to the right hand, and a timeout call.
It's the official's time.
Uh-huh.
Is he worried about a wet spot on the court? I'm not sure.
Must be deemed enough to be able to play for the final 3 seconds. Down to one, Williams. Cross before the buzzer, it's way short, an air ball by Aiden Cross. 26-23. The lead is 3 for the Spartans. And if you're a Naugatuck fan, or rather, if you're the team, you have to be extremely pleased with how they played in that first half. Much differently than the matchup back on January 4th.
Oh, yeah. You need to be within striking distance of a team like Waterbury Career Academy, and Naugatuck is. And I think they've just been converting what they need to convert. They've got a lot of high percentage shots at the rim, and they've taken advantage. They don't need to be making threes to keep this game close, as it's 26-23. And this game is being played at Naugatuck's pace. There's no doubt about that. Naugatuck averages 56 points per game. Waterbury Career Academy almost 83 points a game. How about this for a stat? Waterbury Career Academy averages 82.9 points per game. The season high for Naugatuck is 80. So they don't have one game that has reached the average for Waterbury Career Academy over 20 games. But right now it's much more in Naugatuck's favor, being low scoring and a little slower.
And a one key factor for Naugatuck is the fact that they're 9 of 12 from the free throw line. Career Academy's 4 of 11. That single-handedly, which is something that has been a bugaboo of the Naugatuck Greyhounds, which is making, you know, from the stripe, making those free throws. Them doing that has kept them in this game. At certain points, they had the lead. But the point is, the longer that Naugy continues to execute their plan, and if Career is off, which we've seen right now, they could very well come out in the second half. I've seen it before. They could be draining threes left and right. But the longer that Naugy stays in this, I'm not saying there's going to be an upset between the 1 and the 8. But it'll get interesting late, and then by that point, you just never know.
Yeah, I don't expect Waterbury Career Academy to get nervous, but they have expectations now. This is not a position this team has been in before where they're the favorite. They're the top seed. People expect them to do well. They're supposed to win this game rather easily, and it has been anything but easy through the first 16 minutes.
I agree with you, and it's one of those cases where this is a Naugy team that's been battle-tested. I mean, they've been through the rigors. They're 9-9 in the NVL, 10-10 overall. They're going to be facing whoever they play in Division I is going to be there for a reason, hence why they're in Division I. But I would think this experience that Naugy is getting will help them not just in this game, but however they go if they were able to get this far, get past this point. but also two in the state tournament as well, because with all the players coming back.
Yeah, and they're not focused on next year, that's for sure, at the moment, but they will be in a good position when that time comes.
Now we'll take a quick break. We'll come back with about a minute left of the halftime. I'm Chris Owners alongside Tom Felice. Halftime here from Wilby High School, the Reggie O'Brien Gymnasium. 26-23 is the score. Career is up by three. Chris Saunders alongside Tom Felice as we are just 16 seconds away from the third quarter here from the Reggie O'Brien Gymnasium at Wilby High School in the final game of the quarterfinals in the NVL tournament. The number one seed, Waterbury Pure Academy, and the number eight seed, the Naugatuck Greyhounds. And Tom and I were just going back and forth about both of these teams. And this game, on paper, a lot of people would have thought, oh, Pure Academy is going to wipe the floor early. And you know what? We can go home, do whatever. This game is far from over, ladies and gentlemen. Far from over.
Oh, absolutely. Is Torrington. Naugatuck is playing a very strong game. You don't know how many times during the week I was trying to figure out if it was Torrington or Naugatuck. I did check the bracket every time. Naugatuck is, they're playing very well, and I think they're taking Waterbury Career Academy out of their comfort zone. And so now the question is, what does Waterbury Career Academy do to adjust? They're not a team that had to make a lot of adjustments during the season. You go 17-3, most of the time you're doing what you want to do. And right now they are held to 26 points. Off the top of my head, I don't know if this is their fewest first half points this season, but it's got to be up there. They've been over 60 in every game but two this season.
Inbounding will be Barry as the third quarter is underway between the number eight seed Nagy and number one Career. 3-point lead for the Spartans as Career will be defending left to right. Naugy will be attacking left to right on your screen. Turnover by the Naugatuck Greyhounds. Kennedy, number 12, had 6 points in the first half, averages 19. Sonny Pierce, Desire Lott. Lott, whistle blown, and I think that's going to be
on Career. Pierce.
Yeah, wow. His second.
I think it was a moving screen.
If you look at the average point totals for all the starters, the only one closest to their total is Zaire Lott. He has 10 of his 16.
And he didn't play the final 5 minutes of the first half.
You're right.
After picking up his second foul.
Yep.
But first offensive set, it is Lott going to the basket for Career. And now they're putting on the press. This press has been really difficult for their opponents throughout the season.
Francis throws it, and Yates is able to stay in bounds. Nice footwork by Dasani Yates. As you mentioned, Tom, the press worked.
It's really been a bear to play against when Career Academy is able to implement it.
Jason Kennedy back outside to Yates. Gray in the paint, number 54. And driving is Lott. Lott lost it, had the handle. Actually, rather kept the possession of the basketball when he was out of bounds. So, as we see now again, 4-1 defense, or rather 1-3-1 defense for the Spartans. Gray to the other Gray. Driving, and good. 5 points for Dylan Gray. 1 point lead for the Spartans. 51 points scored total with both teams combined, but it's been close. Yates keeps it in bounds. The possession stays with the Spartans. Fade away by Pierce, a little short off the front iron. And here go the Greyhounds trying to get the lead. What a pass! And what a play by Jason Kennedy! But Moore slipped as he was trying to drive, and he traveled. What a pass by Francis, though.
Yeah.
Threaded the needle on that one.
Yeah, just took out about three players with one pass.
And just unlucky by Moore slipped as he was trying to drive, Tom. 6:10 remaining in the third. 1 point lead for the Spartans. Pierce to Kennedy. Now Drew Williams. Williams guarded by Gray. Back outside to Pierce. Three, a little bit too hard. Moore on the defensive rebound. It stays a 1 point lead for Career. Francis trying to go by. Reverses inside. Comes up unlucky, but the putback is good. Nice play by Dylan Gray. What a job by Naugatuck, as you can hear the timeout call by the Spartans. I'm looking at two different emotions, but also signs with the Spartans. I'm seeing some heads down. I'm seeing emotion down. Naugatuck is as fiery, almost like they're the one seed, and Career's the eight seed. A little bit different right now.
Yeah. This is uncharted territory, really, for Waterbury Career Academy. They've lost three games, but they were against very good teams, known good teams. Danbury, early in the season, Hatters finished 18-2. Then the loss to Kennedy, the loss to Holy Cross. Those are games going in, you know those are going to be dogfights. Maybe coming into this game, you don't think it's going to be like that, but guess what? We're 2 minutes into the second half, and it is, as Naugatuck has retaken the lead.
At what point, I know you said the fourth quarter with the threes, at what point, as far as if you're a Spartans fan, do you start to become concerned? Because one quarter, okay, things are off. At halftime, all right, you make adjustments. We're almost 3 minutes into the third. They still look off. At what point do you start to get concerned?
Now, I'm not sure what you do differently. That's the thing. You know, Waterbury Career Academy is playing their game for the most part, but things just aren't clicking.
Williams trying to get by Gray. Gray using his force in the low post, out of bounds, back over to Nagy. And also, too, Tom, we're seeing a lot of frustration from this Career Academy team.
And, Williams, do you need to try to drive in there, especially with Jabari Gray on the floor? He's so big. The press could be a key to flipping this.
5 second violation. There again is the press by Career, as Barry could not find anybody on his team to be able to get the Peach over to. Peach being the basketball.
I believe it was the Wilby game at home for Career, where they put in the press and it just totally changed the game. It was about a 10-0 run with the ball barely crossing half court.
Caden Moore slams it hard with the left hand and then says something over to Yates, and that's going to cause a technical foul. Not a smart play from Caden Moore. He let the emotions of Yates get the best of him. And there was no need to make that play. Young man's mistake. The two did give Naugy the lead by one. You just hope that he can learn from that in a game that every point counts.
And it counts as a personal foul, and it counts against the 7-10 as well.
But you got to make your free throws, which Career's been bad at in this game. 4 of 12. Naugy, 9 of 12. Second free throw, good. 5 of 13 from the line is Career. We're tied 29-all with 5:01 to go in the third. The Spartans have possession of the basketball. I'm not surprised that Wilson's keeping more in, though.
No, I mean, you need your players in a game like this.
He also wants to see how Moore's going to respond as well. And they're going to call a blocking foul on Gray.
Yeah, I think the official got stuck. He probably didn't want to call that foul, but Williams appeared stepped on the baseline. If Williams had stayed in bounds, official might not blow a whistle. But at the same time, you know, it's getting a little loud in here. Emotion's getting a little high. Wouldn't be surprised to see this game called a bit tighter over the next couple minutes.
Yates gets Gray to bite. Off the hand of Moore. Nice job by Francis and Moore of Naugy. Still tied 29 apiece. 4:43 to go in the third. The one, Career. The eight, Naugy. Almy is in. Nice job by 54, Jabari Gray. Did a nice job until this point of him being able to come out. Did his job.
Yeah, he's very important on the defensive end. I haven't seen him score.
Foul call by Yates. That's going to be his third, team second.
And it's right another one. You know, what are you going to get out of that?
Yeah.
Maybe you get a turnover?
That's the second time. Remember I made the comment earlier in the first half. Why reach in?
Yeah,
on
exactly.
Francis. And there's another reach in.
It looks like that'll be on Kennedy.
That's going to be his first, team third. You talked about the aggressiveness. You don't want to reel that back because that's what makes this team so great.
Exactly.
But at the same time, it's like you're playing with both sides of the sword.
Yeah, you live by and die by.
Yeah, exactly. Francis to Barry. Barry drawing two. Barry trying to make a pass, intercepted by Career. The turnover by Naugy. And then Pierce was hit hard, going down by Gray. Gray's third, team's third. Pierce at the line for two. Pierce, 2 of 5 from the free throw line. He'll be shooting two here. Career as a team, 5 of 13. We're tied 29 all. The first free throw stays 29. In the games that you've done, Tom, have you seen career shoot this bad from the stripe?
They've had their struggles this season.
Okay.
They've had their struggles this season from the line.
But this bad, like to this point, 5 of 14?
I did a lot of their games. But, you know, they've lost a lot of points on the line throughout the year.
There's the press again. Valmy with Naugy breaking it. Naugy down by one. Francis. A little bit too hard. Valmy offensive rebound. He was fouled and counted. A possible three-point play for Vedley Valmy. Team's fourth. 1 point lead for the Greyhounds. And the foul's on Kennedy, his second. Bending the knees is Valmy. And the free throw is missed. Kennedy on the rebound. 5 of 9, Naugy has missed their last 4 free throws. And it's swatted away by Valmy, but they call a foul on Naugy. Team's fourth. And Coach Wilson, rather, stretching out his hands like, yeah, I don't know, that kind of looked pretty clean to me.
Yeah. I think this game really changed when they called that tech.
Yep.
After the slam by Moore.
Like you said, the emotions.
Yeah, and I think, you know, it's gotten even more hard fought and slowed down a little bit. But if Waterbury Career Academy makes their free throws, it's going to really change the game.
Kennedy made the first. We're tied 31. Now we're untied. 8 of 17. 1 point lead for Career. 4:02 to go in the third. Number 8, Naugy. Number 1, Career. Career again with the press. Naugy's able to break it. Dietelbaum over to Barry. Got to get by midcourt, and they do. Francis wearing number 2. Francis. Kennedy going for the steal. They call foul on Kennedy. That's his third. Now you've got Kennedy with 3, Yates with 3, Rossi with 3.
Watt has 2, Pierce has 2.
Yep.
Williams the only one without 2 fouls.
Moore driving, lost it, and the foul is on Lott. No, they're not going to call on Lott, actually.
Team Rossi. 6.
That's going to be Rossi's 4th. So 1 more and he's done. That really shortens the bench for Ronan O'Leary.
Yeah, and you wouldn't be as worried if you weren't playing against Naugatuck, who has Valmy at 6'2", Moore at 6'4", Francis is 6'2", Gray is 6'3", the other Gray is 6'4".
6 of 10 is Naugy from the line. Substitution coming in. As Kennedy is out, crosses back in. Second free throw is no good. Rossi on the rebound. 6 of 11. Moore 1 of 2 from the stripe. 32 all is the score. Pierce goes outside to cross. Cross in the paint. Tries to give it over to Rossi. Correction, that's going to be Pierce. And then Valmy again with the long hands. This Naugatuck team is long on both sides in height and in length. And we're seeing that tonight. Williams, quick pass on the corner. Pierce, catch and shoot. No, off the right side of the iron. Rossi, offensive rebound. Second chance for Career. Cross for 3. No. Rossi again gives it to Williams. The third chance, as Williams was tipped, may have been blocked by Valmy and a crew of Greyhounds.
And Sonny Pierce is able to come away with the ball.
3 minutes to go in the third. We're tied 32 all. Hearing the crowd on the Naugy side saying defense. Francis outside. Nice play from Dietelbaum. But it stays with Career. It's like they have glue to the basketball, Tom. Williams spinning. Nice play. Whistle blown, but he traveled. And the basket will not count. And I think the cheerleaders got confused for Career. They thought the basket counted, but it didn't count. That was a travel.
A long trip at that end, but no result for Waterbury Career Academy.
Barry for Naugy, 3/4 of the court. Naugy going left to right on your screen in their maroon uniforms. We're tied 32 all with 2:30 to go in the third. Francis goes outside to Moore. Moore on the drive, had it hit away, and it's back over to the Spartans. And we've seen now Nagy probably will not attempt a three, probably for this game. It seems like they've sold on driving to the basket and shooting long perimeter shots.
And it's working for them.
It has.
There's a long conversation with the officials, and they're going to give it to Naugatuck.
Barry inbounding behind the Career Academy basket. And Francis will be the inbounder. Lott using his long arms to stay right in front of Francis for Nagy.
He's giving him the inside.
Floats it high to Barry. Williams quickly there for Career. Francis guarded by Williams. Valmy on the pick. Doesn't affect Williams. Francis driving in. Tipped. No whistle blown. Play continues. 2:10 remaining in the third. Cross to Pierce. Pierce inside the three-point line. Nice move. And offensive foul on Career. That's going to be Sonny Pierce's third. Team seven. That was a delayed reaction by the crew.
And it wasn't the baseline official who called it. It was the central official in front of Ronan O'Leary who called it.
Barry inbounding. We're seeing the press again by Career. Francis gets by mid. We're still tied 32-all with 2 minutes to go in the third. Moore working on Rossi. Moore goes in and count it. A possible three-point play for Caden Moore.
And it fouls out Rossi.
That means Rossi is fouled out.
Yeah, they've been sitting Yates on the bench to try to save him with three fouls. And now I don't think you have a choice because Rossi just fouled out.
Rossi doesn't know he fouled out yet.
He put his head down for a while. I think he realized it. And maybe he was trying to hide, but he's too big to hide.
Yates is now back in. Moore at the line for a possible three-point play. Moore with 15 points looking for 16. Francis getting a breather. Dylan Gray is in. This Naugy team feels something different, Tom.
Yeah, and Waterbury Career Academy really doesn't have an answer at the moment.
Gray, the number eight seed. The Naugy team, rather, number eight seed. Misses the free throw. Valmy able to keep it in bounds, but he threw it right over to the Spartans. They're down by two, and Williams ties it up 34-all. And then a whistle blown on Lott.
I think they teed somebody up.
It was on Career. That's on Zaire Lott. Now he gets a tee, and that also gives him a personal. So that's his third.
I don't think it was a technical. I think it was just a push, but it is a foul nonetheless. And that's 18 fouls, but I don't think this will result in free throws. It will. So it was not considered an offensive foul, so it will result in the 1-1.
I think he did get a tech.
The official did the push signal.
Okay.
Yeah, so they're signaling it's going to be the 1-1.
Okay. So there was not tech called, but so Lott just got the personal foul.
But it goes from a made basket. The basket still counts, but now they're right down the other end, and it's a chance for Naugatuck to score. Instead of Waterbury Career Academy being able to put their full court press in after a made hoop.
1:46 to go in the third. We're tied 34-all. Gray at the line for a 1-1. Is no good. Kennedy lost the handle of the basketball, but the possession stays with Career. 6 of 13 is Naugatuck. They've missed their last three free throws. Williams to Pierce. Kennedy on the drive. Foul called on Naugy. The cross wing to come back in. Call that on Dietelbaum. His second, team's fifth. 1:31 in the third. Neither team seems like they want to get out to a comfortable lead, Tom.
Oh, neither team is going to let the other one do it.
That's very true. Pierce inbounding behind the Naugatuck basket, outside the three-point line. Williams was able to get Gray. Yates, nice pass. Pierce can't get by the trees, but there's Cross to put away the garbage. His first points of the game puts career up by two. 1:10 remaining in the third. Berry, back to Francis. Possession career. Williams bringing up the basketball, wearing number 24. Has 8 points. Kennedy working on Moore. Loose ball picked up by Cross. Williams, long range. No, misses the three. Moore hit it right to Yates. Yates kicks it back outside to Sonny Pierce. It is pure! 30 by Sonny Pierce. 5 points for Pierce in the third. Down under 30 seconds in said quarter. 39-34 career. 22 seconds to go. Francis. Outside. Gray. And he traveled. 11 points for Sonny Pierce in the game.
And Zaire Lott checks in. Get your top players, offensive players on the court for the last possession of the quarter.
15 seconds to go. Berry, now Francis, throws it right over to Gray. Gray on the interception. Gray was hit, no foul call, but he makes the basket anyway. He has 9 points, down to 1 second. Williams before the buzzer is short. A 3-point lead for the Spartans as we head to the fourth quarter. 39-36. Now Coach Wilson trying to have a conversation with one of the Zebras. And this game is quite exciting, Tom.
Yeah, it's had just about everything except for a lot of points. But it's still a close game. And Naugatuck is right in it. This is all you ask for if you're the Greyhounds, is be in the game, be in a position going into the fourth quarter to keep this close and have a chance, because they really stymied Waterbury Career Academy. This is not the type of game that Waterbury Career Academy is used to playing.
Leading scores through three quarters, you've got leading for Waterbury Career Academy, Sonny Pierce with 11. And for Naugatuck, it's Caden Moore with 15. Like you mentioned, I want to go back to that technical foul. I almost wonder, did that kind of in some ways, I don't want to say drive the passion, because I feel like that was already there. But we don't know what happens behind the scenes and on social media and all that. And I'm sure there's a lot of stuff talked between both. But also the fact that you've got a lot of people who were sleeping on Naugatuck thinking that Career was just going to win this game handily. Naugatuck's making it extremely difficult.
Yeah, and I think, when that technical happened, it turned everything up a notch. The energy seemed to raise, not just on the court, but throughout the whole gym. And Waterbury Career Academy, they've answered. They're winning, so they're not in a bad position. But they are facing an opposition of a type they really haven't faced this year. They've been able to blow teams like this out for the most part. And now the challenge will be, can they do it in the fourth quarter?
Francis regains the handle to Moore. Naugatuck down by three. Have yet to make a three in this game. Will be a good time if they made one here. Francis, picked by Valmy. Quickly, there's Kennedy, guarded two. Valmy, and a reach-in foul by Career.
That's the four fouls now on Lott.
One more, and he's done. That's 10 team fouls at the line for two. Will be Naugatuck and Valmy. You can't afford to lose a lot.
No.
Right. Out of the five, I would say right now, currently in this game, you need a lot more than anything.
I think the official just gave a warning, an official warning to the Waterbury Career Academy bench.
First free throw, no good. There's two free throws.
That was a 10th team foul, so they're shooting two.
Yep, should be two.
You mentioned Lott. He didn't score in the third quarter, and
no.
he had 8 points the first quarter. He has just two since.
Yep.
So if he's going to stay on the court with four fouls, I think he's got to do something on the offensive end to make it worth it, considering he might have to take his foot off the gas on the other end of the court.
Tom, that's a great point. If you're not going to score, you got to do something. Defensively, anything. 7:20 to go in the game. Lott for three. Tried to pull it for a long-range three. Couldn't make it. One and done his career. Francis working on Pierce. Francis spinning by. Francis to Gray to tie it. No, but there's Barry on the offensive rebound. Finds Caden Moore for the two. 17 for Caden Moore. 1 point lead for the Spartans, 39-38. Williams working on two, whistle blown. Is it going to be on Moore or Valmy? And it will be on Moore. His second, team's sixth. Julian's at the line for two.
This has been a struggle today for Waterbury Career Academy.
8 of 17, has not been pretty.
And they're in the bonus now, so they'll be shooting the rest of the way. Both teams will.
Free throw missed, 8 of 18. 1 point lead, it stays for Career. Second free throw is missed again. Lott gets the offensive rebound, kicks it back out to Kennedy, and Kennedy can't make the three either. Nothing going right for the Spartans in this quarter, Tom.
No. I'm surprised they didn't blow a whistle before that second free throw. The PA started playing.
I heard the music. Throwing out of bounds was Naugy, and they're giving. You think about Naugy's missed opportunities. You miss two free throws. You miss a chance to maybe make a basket there. Giving away opportunities.
Mm-hmm.
Against Career, like you said, you can't do that.
No. But the defense is held up. They're still only down by one.
Lott. Sonny Pierce swinging around the three-point line with Career. Kennedy, the pull-up. No, he misses. Stays a one-point lead for the Spartans.
And sometimes the shots just don't fall.
Could be just one of those nights.
Yeah.
Francis, three. No, he misses. Naugy still yet to make a three in the game. On transition, give and go. Williams, tip. They don't call anything. They're letting him play.
Give Bedley the block. Down near the block.
Francis driving inside. No. Moore has it for Naugy, then he slipped. And that's the third time that Moore has slipped in that spot. I am surprised that there has not been somebody there to wipe that up.
Yeah.
Because Moore has slipped there three times now.
The officials go into it now.
It's kind of too late now. Two times I thought would be enough.
Well.
Because you got to think about the injury factor.
Well, it's going to dry up eventually, so it hasn't been the same thing.
High-intensity game between both teams. 1 point lead for Career. Under six to play in the game. Chris Saunders alongside Tom Felice. The fourth game of the NVL tournament. The winner will take on Seymour on Monday with time to be determined. Williams. Top of the key. Lott, catch and shoot. Felsy shot. And it's going to be three free throws, and Lott is known for doing that.
Yeah, well, that was he drew that.
Correct.
I shouldn't say, that was a foul. He didn't have to draw that foul. He was fouled on that play. But, yeah, he goes down pretty easy when he shoots his three.
He sells it. He sells it well.
Yeah, I don't think he needed to sell that one. I think Barry got him pretty good.
First free throw, good. Barry's third personal foul, team's seventh. 2 point lead for Career, 3 point lead for Career.
I've got Lott at 4 of 5 now with one more coming at the line. He's taking advantage at the stripe. It's been a struggle for the rest of his team.
Third free throw is short. Off of Naugatuck. Stays a 3-point lead for the Spartans with under 5:40 to play in the game. Number one, career, number eight, Naugatuck. Naugy not playing like an eight seed, staying strong. Three by Lott, a little bit short. Yates able to keep it for a second, and then off of Naugatuck.
That's what Dasani Yates brings to this team. The senior averages under 2 points a game, but his hustle plays like that that earn an extra possession will go a long way for Waterbury Career Academy the rest of this game and the rest of the season.
Travel by Kennedy. We have not seen Career go farther than seven deep. We have not seen Etzen. We have not seen Bracey. We have not seen Williams, Simmons. They went to Rossi and Cross, and that's it.
And Rossi's fouled out.
Correct. So really, they've only gone six deep now.
Yeah.
Francis with the ball rolling, continuing to roll. Last touch by Career. And Francis, I don't know if he's looking for a foul, but I have to admit,
he's lucky he didn't get called for a foul.
That's the first part. The second part is these officials are letting the game, which has been highly physical, a lot of emotion, they're letting them play.
Yeah.
But they're also knowing on when to draw the line. We saw the technical foul with Moore. They nipped it in the bud there. I thought there was going to be a tech on Lott. There was not one. But they were able to calm things down when they had to before it escalated.
Yeah, and you know, there's a reason these guys are on this game.
This is true.
There's not a lot of games in the state. Most of the conferences playing their quarterfinals today, so you're going to get some of the high-level refs in this game and hopefully the rest of the year.
Now, we look at potential matchups as far as only one we're waiting on. We know that Holy Cross will take on Kennedy. Again, TBA, time to be determined. And then we've got Seymour taking on the winner of this game. And, I mean, to be honest, whoever wins this game goes into Seymour with both teams really having to go through a highly contested game. Now, there's going to be time in between, but when you have games like that, I've always wondered, is there any sort of, not repercussions, but is there any, you know, from the days on, do you still feel that even after?
They're high school kids. they get hit by a car and bounce right back up most of the time, you know. But I think at this time of year, yeah, you're feeling it a little bit, but nothing's going to slow you down, especially, you know, you get about a week after the conference tournament to reset. So you go every other day for the next 4 days, get a little break, and then you have the state tournament.
Sonny Pierce took it away from Francis, and then a foul call by Naugy, or rather on Naugy, I should say. And they're going to call that on Valmy.
Yeah, he ran into Pierce, tripped him up from behind.
Can't do that. Under five to play in the game. Valmy's second, team's eighth. 1-1 for Sonny Pierce. Has 11 points. Averages 19. Naugy 10, or rather career 10 of 22 from the free throw line. Making now 10 of 23. Francis with Naugy down by three. Barry with Gray. Now Francis again. Francis with six. Did not score in the third quarter. Francis to Barry. Barry in the corner to Gray. Now Barry again, switching over to Gray in the left low post. Gray on the fadeaway. No, he misses.
And he had the advantage there because Lott has four fouls and he was shading off of them.
Lott on the drive. Lott was fouled. And they're going to call that on Valmy.
I think they got Barry.
Interesting. I thought Valmy kind of gave a little bit of a hand at the end of that.
That's four on Barry.
Okay. Team's ninth. 1-1 for Lott. There's two of three earlier. Makes another one here. 11 of 24. This may be the end of the game here where Lott may have to take over as long as he's in the game.
Yeah, he's got to stay on the court, though, as he's working with four fouls. He hasn't come out since he picked up the fourth foul. That was over 3 minutes ago.
Yeah.
So it's a sign of trust from Ronan O'Leary in Lott, one of the most important players for this team.
Gray to Francis. Francis guarded by Lott. Valmy setting the pick. Nowhere to go for Naugatuck there, so Francis retreats. Under four to play in the game, 42-38, career. Off the end of Pierce, it stays with Naugy. Valmy on the fade, five-footer. Nice touch from Valmy. He's got eight. Two-point lead for the Spartans. Like you said, Tom, neither team wants to either get ahead or be down by a lot.
Yeah, the defense isn't going to let it happen, that's for sure.
No. Pick by Yates. Made some room for Williams. Went to his right hand, switched over. No whistle blown. Francis had the basketball. And a push by Yates. That gives him four.
And where has he picked up his last two fouls? 90 feet from the hoop.
Yep. You are 100% correct. Tom, you sure you don't want to coach? Come on.
I'm telling you, man. I'm telling you, man.
Coach the little guys.
It would not be good for anyone involved. Well, it might be okay for me, but it would not be good for the players.
Two free throws for Francis. Doggies missed their last five free throws. They'll have two here. First free throw by Francis. Good. 7 of 16. Neither team has really shot free throws well. Naugy did early, and then they've kind of reverted back to their original ways.
But Francis is. I've got him at 5 of 5.
Yes, I do too. And we're tied 42 all. 8 of 17. Francis coming up big, number 2 for Naugy. 3:20 remaining in the game. Sonny Pierce, top of the key. Francis guarding, Yates on the pick. Give and go to Yates. Yates retreats back to Pierce. Pierce from the stripe, and it's no good. Yates got the offensive rebound. Yates goes in, doesn't have it. Moore picks up the ball, and then a whistle blown. That's on Yates. He's fouled out. Two players for career fouled out. Rossi and now Yates. And now you have to go to somebody that you haven't used yet, or do you go to Cross, but then you kind of minimize what bigs that you now have lost.
Well, you don't have another big, really, unless they go to David Rivera, and that's going deep in the bench.
That's who I was thinking, yeah.
I think that this could be a blessing in disguise, where now you're not trying to match up with Naugatuck with the height. They'll bring in Zaire Etzen. You're not trying to match up the same way with the height, and maybe this opens the game up for Waterbury Career Academy. Maybe.
Are you saying as far as maybe speeding the game, stretching the floor a little bit more?
Yeah.
Okay. First free throw by Moore. Good. Moore now with 18 points. Naugy 9 of 18 from the line.
First lead of the quarter.
Substitution coming in. Dietelbaum is in, and Valmy is out. I would expect that Valmy will be back at some point. He's been a nice piece off the bench for Naugatuck on both rebounding sides.
He has been, but you see a guard come in for a forward.
Free throw made. Tom, you were saying?
I think Naugatuck recognizes the matchup as well.
Two-point lead for the Greyhounds over number one career. Three, bang, by Zaire Lott. Career is back up by one. And that's why you need Zaire Lott.
Yeah, that was from NBA range. That was a deep three. And it was right in front of the bench. Coach O'Leary looked worried for a second until the shot went through.
That's like the no, 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 yes, yes, yes.
And then a five-second violation. The defense getting the job done right there for Waterbury Career Academy.
Cross will be coming in. Out will be Etzen. I'm sure a lot of people were thinking, why are you shooting that? Oh, wait, no, good. I'm glad you shot it.
Yeah. If there's anybody else but Zaire Lott.
All right. I mean, he can make it from anywhere. He's got range very long. Kennedy. And the basket, well, I'm waiting to see.
That's not going to count. They called a charge. And that's
I was waiting to see because I saw people cheer. I saw people excited again. Then I see Naugy being excited.
It's a tough call because both officials are straight on. They can't see between the players. And that's four fouls now on Kennedy.
Yeah. One more and he's done. Would you say this is probably career's not good game that you've seen?
Oh, absolutely. And credit to Naugatuck. You know, they are making it happen.
Substitution coming in. Dietelbaum is out. Valmy back in, like you talked about before. Wilson subbing, of which O'Leary is subbing. 2:18 remaining in the game. Naugy's down by one. Number 8, Naugy. Number 1, career. Francis. And no. Moore puts it up. No, he misses. Volmy puts it in. No, he misses. Volmy again. No. Volmy for a fourth time, and he finally puts it in. Does Bentley Volmy. He's got 10. The lead is 1 for the Greyhounds. Under 2 to play in the game. Kennedy goes up. Whistle blown. At the line for 2, Jason Kennedy. And the foul is going to be on Francis. That's his third. 10 fouls for both teams. I can imagine, Tom, how difficult it is with the emotions and everything to have to try to harness that in a transition situation just like that.
Yeah.
It's got to be hard.
No, and you just need to take that extra beat, that extra second, and make sure you're executing the way you want to.
Tom, you may need some Tums after this. 11 of 26.
I'm not the coach, remember.
This is true. Second free throw is short again. Kennedy got the rebound, but the foul's going to be on Career.
I think it might be a lane violation.
If it is, it would be a foul. I did not see a foul called.
Yeah,
so must have just been a lane violation. It had to be. 11 of 27. Full court press. No, the Spartans drop. A 1-point lead for the Greyhounds. Barry to Gray. Naugy trying to upset the one seed, Career. Gray to Francis. Francis still dribbling the basketball. Goes outside to Gray. Gray decides to retreat. Zyaretson guarding. And then a timeout called by Wilson with 1:28 to go in the game. 1-point lead, it stays for Naugy.
So Waterbury Academy, what do you plan to do here? How long do you try to force a steal before you commit a foul? And do you keep Lott on the floor with 4 fouls, Candy on the floor with 4 fouls, knowing that at some point on this possession, you might need to give a foul. You might need to give a foul before you can sub anybody again.
As far as the foul troubles are concerned, Lott has 4, Kennedy has 4, Pierce has 3 for Career. And for Naugatuck, you've got 4 for Barry, 3 for Gray, 3 for Francis. And that's really all that's it as far as foul trouble.
3 fouls isn't much foul trouble with a minute 28 to go.
This is true. But the key would be more so for Career, because you've got 4 on Lott and you've got 4 on Kennedy. If you're Naugatuck, you almost force Lott or Kennedy to have to make a play and have them risk fouling out.
I don't think you worry too much about who you can get to foul you.
Okay.
As your Naugatuck, I think you just need to focus on keeping the basketball and making the team foul you, because if you turn the ball over, we see what Warwick Academy can do in transition. You want to keep possession of the ball if you're Naugatuck for as long as you can.
1:28 remaining in the game, coming out of the timeout, as Naugatuck called it. Inbounding will be Gray. Also have Moore, Francis, Valmy, and Barry. Gray gets it over to Barry. Barry guarded by Kennedy. Puts it over to Gray. Gray lost the ball. Not a good job by Naugatuck. 1:18 to go. Career's down by 1. Sonny Pierce with Francis staring him down, stretching out his right arm. The pick by Etzen. Pierce on the drive. And Pierce will finish in the right low post. He's got 13. Down to a minute remaining in the game. Francis lost it. Ball's on the ground. Players fall. No whistle blown. Now it's blown. And a timeout called by Career. The lead is 1 for the Spartans. And Francis was trying to make a case that he got basically bulldozed. But again, they're letting him play.
It's going to take a lot to get a foul like that.
That's true.
At this point in the game.
Like you said, there's going to have to be a lot that happens. And even that is considered a lot. There may have to be more than that.
Yeah, it's a loose ball. You know, you're going to dive. People are going to dive on the ground. They're going to do whatever they can to get the ball. So I mean, it's a little different when you're driving in the hoop as it is when there's a loose ball on the deck.
As you've seen, and we both have seen in football, fumble.
Yeah.
Every man for himself.
Yeah.
I can only imagine what happens in those dog piles. I've heard stories.
Oh, yeah.
So I can only imagine what happens there.
Yeah, not pretty. But not pretty at all.
So Career will be coming out of their timeout. They called it. Ronan heads up play. As soon as Career got the possession, they called the timeout.
Yeah. I think he was probably calling it even before then.
That's true.
He was signaling it just very quickly because they want this possession. And now, you know, they need to – do you just pass the ball around? Do you try to stall if you're Waterbury Career Academy? Do you try to go to the hole? Does Naugatuck foul at any point? A lot of strategy to go over this final minute.
A one-point lead for the Spartans. Naugy has not backed down this entire game, basically from tip. Nope. They have been in it.
It started out 5-0 Waterbury Career Academy. You're thinking, oh, here we go, blowout. Six straight points from Naugatuck, and they had a lead at 6-5 in the early going. It's been close ever since.
Sonny Pierce gets the inbound pass from Kennedy. Drew Williams, one-point lead for the Spartans, down to 50 seconds remaining in the game. Kennedy outside, Williams to Pierce. At what point, Naugy may have to basically foul. Kennedy from the left corner. No. Fighting for the ball. Whistle blown. Possession.
Stays.
Yes. It's hard to tell at the scoring table because where the possession arrow is, it looks like they're both basically pointing on
now,
both sides.
The scorer for Naugatuck is trying to say that it's Naugatuck ball, but you know, we got three officials in charge of this, and they keep track of the arrow as well.
It was supposed to be Naugy basketball. Everybody is saying it too.
Only from the Naugatuck side. The officials keep it. They usually keep like a little rock or a rubber band or something. They switch from one pocket to the other. Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that. That's pretty cool. Williams lost the handle, regains back to Lott. Lott floats it high to Etzen. Now they're playing keep away, and Naugy finally commits a foul with under. I mean, they wasted about 40 seconds right there.
Well, Coach Wilson was calling for the foul, and it took a couple of seconds for it to happen. And I think he's going to get an explanation about the possession arrow.
Yeah, they're playing. I mean, you got the scoring person who keeps track of the book for Naugy. You've got Wilson as well. Wilson hearing it. I mean, Wilson typically does not react much. So when he's told something, he's like, okay. Because you can't change anything. What's done is done. But now you put a player who has not shot a free throw all game.
Yeah.
Who's been on the bench basically all game.
Yeah, interesting spot for Zaire Etzen.
Fouls on Valmy. First free throw, good. Case could be made if Career wins this game, Etzen may be the MVP, making big free throws here.
Yeah.
Because now you force Naugy to have to almost shoot a three, which they have not made all game. If he makes this, does Etzen. Mending, Etzen, free throw's good. Ice in his veins, Zaire Etzen. A three-point lead for Career and a timeout call by Naugatuck.
Just a 30-second timeout for Waterbury Career Academy. The question is, do you put on the full court press? I think you do because it just makes things so difficult for the opponent. And I think you're okay giving up a two if you're Waterbury Career Academy. You don't want to give up points, but you would rather Naugatuck make a two than take a three, in my opinion, even though they haven't hit too many threes.
But if you're going to let them make a two or at least give that illusion like you are, you can't foul them.
No.
Because then obviously becomes a three-point play. Yeah. While Naugy has struggled from the free throw line, they're big-time guys who have made free throws have been Francis and Caden Moore.
I think you want to put yourself in a position where you either slow down the offense in the backcourt, or if they do break it, that they want to go to the hoop. And if they take a pull-up three in transition and hit it, that's the way it goes sometimes. But no surprise to see Sonny Pierce standing around the free throw line and the full-court press coming for Waterbury Career Academy.
Good call by you, Tom. Moore inbounding. Moore looking. Valmy. Back over to Gray. Down to 10 seconds. 9 seconds. Gray. Offensive foul on Gray. And you could say that Career Academy was basically waving out the worm and Naugy Bip at the line for two.
No, it's a player control foul. They got inbound the ball. The offensive foul, you won't shoot.
Oh, you're right. Good point. Kennedy inbounding to Williams, down to six. Quick foul by Francis. His fourth. Two free throws coming. All Career needs to do is make one, and this game would all be up, all but about be over. But what a game by the Greyhounds. Did not play like an eight seed and gave Career everything they could in this game. First free throw is good, and that could just all about do it. 14 of 30 from the free throw line is Drew Williams. 5.8 seconds to go. 4-point lead. 5-point lead. Naughty down. Francis down to four, down to three. The three is short. And the Waterbury Career Academy Spartans, for the fifth time, are heading to the semifinal. They hold off the Fighting Greyhounds. But the Spartans were just a little bit too much for Naugatuck. The final 51-46. The Spartans will take on Seymour with the time to be determined on Monday. Tom, what a game.
Yeah, and one thing I'm thinking about at the end of this game is Waterbury Career Academy is celebrating because they got the win. This, I haven't seen every game. This might have been their toughest game this year, and they were able to come out on top and get the win, and you saw a big celebration, especially from the seniors like Pierce and Kennedy and Yates, as I think they might have learned a lot today. Learned a lot about themselves, learned a lot about tournament play. Tournament play when you're wearing the white jerseys as the higher seed, as they know that they have a lot more to come, and it started with getting the win in this one.
Well, I think you raise a great point, Tom, because it showed that this was definitely their F game, if not their C, like C minus, F plus, whatever. Like, this was not their best game, and they still were able to not just win the game, but in games, this had a state tournament kind of atmosphere where everything's not going well, because you mentioned how the seeds that they would be playing, obviously Career in terms of seeding would be favored. Well, there could be a game like this, maybe not an 8 seed, but you never know. You'd be facing a 25 that is very competitive, like Naugy with the 8. And Career needs games like this, and it bodes well for them going forward.
Yeah, they're going to be the 2 seed, it looks like, in Division 2, in Division 3, I should say. So your first game's going to be against the winner of the 15-18 game. Then you're probably going to play the 7 seed.
Yep.
And you're going to get teams like this that play like this that give you a different look. And you need to be able to adjust. And for Waterbury Career Academy, they've passed their first test. I think their goal is to win 6 more games after today. That will give them an NVL title and a state title. And they're 1 of 7 right now.
Tom, something about you and games being competitive and not even competitive, just so you know what, awesome. But great to be able to work with you as always and calling these games with you. I look forward to being able to see you at the Sun. Maybe we can hit the craps table on the way to some of the games.
I keep it close on the floor, but on the tables, I don't know about that. That's an instant L right there.
The final here from the Reggie O'Brien Gymnasium in Game 4 of the NVL Tournament. Naugy loses to Career 51-46. So the matchups on Monday will go as followed. Torrington plays, or not Torrington, I should say. Now I pulled you. I pulled you. That's, I knew it.
I'm bringing you down.
No, never. If anything, you make the broadcast. Holy Cross will take on Kennedy, and Career Academy will take on Seymour. Time to be determined, and Mother Nature as well on Monday. But for Tom Felice, for Gabe the camera guy, I'm Chris Saunders. So long, everybody, from the Reggie O'Brien Gymnasium. We'll see you, God willing, on Monday. So long, everybody.